The odds are very good you live not far from nuclear waste, sitting slowly, decaying in temporary concrete casks like these. The odds are also very good you've been paying to get rid of it, in a small fee added every month to your electricity bill. But despite more than $37 billion collected so far by the federal government to maintain, store, and secure the nation's nuclear waste, it has not happened. And here it sits.
So we've got 32 fuel assemblies that are stored in each one of these canisters.
Jerry Bischoff runs the Dominion Nuclear Power Plant in Louisa County, Virginia, which means he also runs the temporary storage site for the plant's spent nuclear fuel. You are looking at 15 years worth of that waste, temporarily stored on site, waiting for the federal government to decide where to put it.
That's right. The federal government was supposed to take possession of spent fuel from commercial nuclear facilities. And it's been a struggle over the years to find the correct site, and then Yucca Mountain was developed, a lot of money was invested. But that facility right now, the licensing of that facility has been suspended.
Yucca Mountain is the $10 billion nuclear waste repository that Congress first started back in 1982, passed again in 1987, and again in 2002.
Yucca Mountain is the most thoroughly researched site of its
to become the one place where all this waste would go. So why isn't Yucca Mountain open? Nobody really wants a nuclear waste dump in their state. And powerful U.S. Senator Harry Reid promised his state's voters he would personally shut it down. Despite Yucca Mountain being the law of the land, that is exactly what Harry Reid managed to do. Reid wouldn't comment for this story, but Gregory Yatsko did. Yatsko is Reid's controversial, hand-picked former chairman of the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, who oversaw the defunding of Yucca Mountain.
I mean, it simply was a project that was going nowhere and is now dead. So it was never going to
well,
be
Well, I mean,
successful.
You say it was going nowhere and now dead. It's going nowhere and now dead because of you and precisely because of Senator Reid not funding it.
Well, at the end of the day.
Isn't that the end of the day?
At the end of the day.
He didn't want it. And he wanted to get reelected. Nevada politics said as much. And at the end of the day, this law, it was defunded.
Ultimately, Yucca Mountain was a failed public policy experiment. And so as we go forward to look at this nuclear waste problem, we have to do it in a way that gets the buy-in from the communities, or we will be in the same place that we were with Yucca Mountain, which is a site will never get built.
So instead of one nuclear waste site out in the middle of the Nevada desert, there are dozens and dozens of them just like this scattered across the country.
Is it safe? Yes, for now. But Bob Alvarez, an anti-nuclear activist and former senior policy advisor at the Department of Energy, says don't wait too long.
They've become major radioactive waste management operations and are not being treated as such. And we have to come to terms with that and have a national policy to have this stuff safely stored and not in so-called interim jury-rigged storage systems.
And that's the real problem. We still have the waste. It isn't going anywhere, just sitting. What was temporary, now for years, waiting for Yucca Mountain to open or waiting for another Yucca Mountain to be found. Drew Girffin, CNN, Washington.
This evening on CNN, a special report, Pandora's Promise, a look at the future of nuclear energy that airs tonight at 9 Eastern only on CNN.